Welcome to Faces and Places. Today we have a tremendous lineup for you, and we just hope you'll sit back and relax and enjoy our program. We've got dancing, we've got singing, and plenty of entertainment, along with some of your favorite video. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the program. We'll be right back with you.
If I were you, I'd take a call.
Hello and welcome back to Faces and Places. If my next guest looks familiar to you, you may have seen him on Dance Party, Party Machine, I'm sorry, and also that's with Mia People, and also on Soul Train, and some of the other TV stations. His name is Eric Medel. Eric, welcome to the program. And it's such a pleasure to have you here. I've seen you on TV. As a matter of fact, I saw you just the other day dancing on the Dance Machine with Mia People. Talk a little bit about that experience.
Well, Party Machine is really nice. You get to do what you want, and there's a lot of dancers you get to meet. You get to see the people up close, and you get to see our studio.
Now, he produces that, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Mm-hmm. Now, how long have you been on the Dance Machine?
We started taping in December. I've been there ever since the first day we started, and I pretty much know him. Yeah, she pretty much knows me.
Mm-hmm. What kind of person is she?
She's really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice, but, you know.
Yeah.
Up to take it. Because everybody goes
to her. Yeah.
Oh, what's your name?
And she's also married to Howard Hewitt, isn't
she? Right.
Right. Great. So they're keeping along with the family, their entertainment wise, huh? Mm-hmm. Great. Now, you, was Soul Train your first professional gig?
Yeah, both of them were my first dance show.
And tell us a little bit about that, Mr. Cornelius.
Okay. Mr. Cahoon is really nice. And consulting really gives you a lot of opportunities if you stay there that long.
Mm-hmm.
But I wasn't, you know, interested in that. I was just interested in dancing.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I was doing Party Machine.
Mm-hmm. And Party Machine seems to be more geared towards you. I mean, it's a different type. It's the now type dancing. It's an upgraded, real fast-paced type program. When does it air? And
it airs Monday through Saturday from 12 to 12:30 after your Arsenio show.
Mm-hmm. And several things about you, Eric, that really impressed me. And one is that you are a choreographer. First of all, you're young. And I think it's just, I love to see young people like yourself getting out and getting involved in the field of entertainment. But you're also a choreographer, and you've got some credits to your name. Tell us a little bit about your choreography.
I choreographed The King and I.
That was at Linwood High School.
Yeah, and I also choreographed an award show they had a few days ago, one week ago. I've been working with Massey for a long time.
Mm-hmm. Now, Ms. Massey is the...
She's the performing arts coordinator.
Mm-hmm.
At Linwood High School.
Now, did you go to Linwood High School? Were you?
Yes, I did. I graduated in 1988.
1988. Yeah. So you're going back and giving back to the community, which that's great, man. That's really great. Now, you're currently enrolled at Toledo's College.
Right.
And what do you study?
Studying. Well, I'm in performing arts, but I go towards dance.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about your style of dance. We were talking earlier, and you have. I'm not going to say a different style, but it's a unique style of dancing. I call it soul with class. And that's not to say the soul has no class, but you put a little extra emphasis on the technical end of dance. Explain your style.
Okay. What I do is every time I work on a piece, I like to hear the different sounds that a song has, and I start thinking about steps. And if it fits, I'll use it.
Uh-huh.
And so I put more emphasis in that. Into that, so that when the beat comes, step,
I hear you. Now, I first saw you at Linwood High School at a talent show. And to me, that's sort of like the Apollo Theater of Linwood, if you will. if you don't do well, it's, the Sandman's going to hit you, right? But they went crazy over you, man. They were screaming, and the girls were going all crazy and everything. And I think Arturo Campos, one of our cameramen, was getting a little happy himself. What do you attribute that to? Did the soul music play a big important part of your style?
Well, I like to listen to a lot of different variety of songs.
Mm-hmm.
But I really do like, you know, to work on a general basis with everything, not only with soul, but, you know, jazz.
That's another thing I wanted to bring up. I like you have a little jazz, a little modern dancing in what you do. What do you hope to be? In the next few years?
Well, in the future, I'm working on, well, I like to get my dance straightened out before I go out into the world and work, dance with somebody. So I really like to be a professional performer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, acting, dancing, or whatever.
Well, let's talk about acting. You had a part and a picture that's going to be released. What's the name of it? What do you like?
Made to Dare is releasing in the summer. And I'll play on my busboy.
Busboy,
yeah.
All right, we're going to look forward to seeing you on that.
Okay.
And in a minute or two, we're going to have you come out and dance. Who are your mentors? Who do you look up to?
Dancing-wise, I would say Fred Astaire, Sammy Davis Jr., Mikhail Bershnikov.
That's a big company, man. A little bit of that.
Singers? Let's see. I would say a little bit of... Michael Jackson, Diana Ron.
Diana Ron.
Yeah.
They pretty much run side to side themselves. Well, in more ways than one. Sorry, Michael. I just have a thing about Michael, I think. Well, anyway, another story, another program. The last time I went off on James Brown, I got a message, so I better leave Michael alone. Anyway, he was good. What are you going to do for us tonight?
I will be dancing to This Time for Fun by, what is her name? Tracy Spencer.
Tracy Spencer. Okay, and we're gonna check you out, and I know you're going to do a bang-up job. And once again, we'll continue to see you on the dance machine. See you doing your thing there. And you don't quite look like yourself, so folks, when you start looking for Eric, you know, you got to look real good. You got to see. It's a little different when he's there. What's on that show, what do they tell you? You say that you do pretty much what you want to do. Well,
it seems like some of that stuff is pretty much choreographed. Some of the people that I see there.
Well, when we get there, we go into the set and groups get together and they do their own little thing. And that's how you see a lot of people dancing together and everything is choreographed. But you get to do a lot of, you know, freestyle and everything. And that's what's good about it, that they don't tell you, okay, you can't do this, you can't do that, you know.
Okay. We're going to see you freestyle in just a few minutes.
Yeah.
And I can't wait because I know you're bad, man. You're bad.
Thank you.
So when we come back, we'll be seeing Mr. Eric Medell from The Dance Machine freestyling here. And I think you're going to like it. We'll be right back.
I'm so smooth, power-packed in speed, I'm a lyrical tycoon. Strong with physical grip, lift and hit, and more feet.